Hey everybody, good morning. It's Tiffany with GF Mom Certified, and this week is Thanksgiving here in the U.S. I know Canada, you've already had your Thanksgiving, so. So let's talk a little bit about getting prepared for the Thanksgiving Day week, and for Thursday especially, because if you've got food allergies like our family, which I know some of you do, or if you're gluten-free or have celiac disease, family holidays are emotional, right? Family holidays bring back memories of food you could eat, food you might want to eat again, foods that, you know, like my one daughter will be like, I'll just take a little bit. No, you won't just take a little bit, because if you just take a little bit, you're going to be whining and complaining later about your stomach hurting, or we're going to be having some behavior issues. So again, those memories that come, you know, with me, my grandma's passed away, but her chocolate pie was like every year. Oh my goodness, we loved her chocolate pie. I couldn't eat her chocolate pie the way she made it, to be honest. I couldn't have the dairy. I couldn't eat the gluten full crust. I couldn't eat the homemade whipped cream out of the full fat, you know, heavy cream. But there's no reason I can't still eat grandma's chocolate pie if we do it safe. And so as we go into the holiday season, I kind of wanted to talk a little bit about that. You've got to be an advocate. You have to be vocal for yourself and for your children especially. Your kids may and may not be old enough to speak for themselves at these holiday dinners. And if somebody were to hand them a cookie or hand them, you know, a piece of cheese or a cracker or a piece of salami, and they've got an allergen, whether it be gluten, dairy, eggs, they're going to have a reaction of some sort. It may not be anaphylactic. It may not be eczema, but it will affect them. It will affect them behaviorally. It'll make them more tired. It might make them irritable. They might get a rash. They might get diarrhea. They might vomit. And then you've got the worst case, like my little Lily, and then she has to have a shot, you know, and we got to do an epinephrine, and we got to take her to the emergency room. It's not worth it. So I'm not saying don't go. Definitely go. We're planning to go to great grandpa's. Great grandpa has no concept of allergies. He just thinks our kids eat weird food. But you have to, as a parent, you have to keep your kids safe. So let's do a little bit of talking about that today, okay? First and foremost, good probiotic, right? Probiotics aren't going to keep you from getting sick, but they're going to keep you from all the aftermath, right? If your gut is healthy, there's less chance of an intolerance. There's less chance of a leaky gut where the food proteins are getting back into your body to make you, you know, have inflammation and all of that stuff going on. So there's different kinds of probiotics. You can definitely do yogurt. You can do the all the probiotic stuff that you can drink and the kefirs. Just know that they only attack the upper half of your system. Once they get into your stomach, the stomach acid kills 99% of that. So it will help in the upper digestive tract. But once you get to your lower digestive tract, you do need something that is more spore-based and is not active and living at the time when you ingest it. So what our family's been taking is a Thrive probiotic. And this is spores. As crazy as it sounds, it comes from dirt. They're not shoveling dirt into a bottle by any means, but it is spores that we would have got naturally if we were still eating things fresh from the garden or fresh from the farmer. And anymore, we all know we overwash our vegetables. We soak them in all this stuff to get the chemicals off. But in doing that, you don't necessarily get the spores that you need for your lower gut. And these, like I said, they're not eating dirt. They're actually a pill. And you can pop them open, which is what I do for the kids. Put them in oatmeal. I put them in yogurt. Things like that. But this Thrive probiotic will actually help your lower gut stay healthy during the holiday season. Now, don't go out and just eat something knowing you're allergic to it. It's not going to help you there. But it's going to help you from getting constipated or from getting diarrhea. It's going to help your leaky gut, your inflammation, okay? So if you need to get this, hop over to our website. I've got a link. In our store, you can buy Thrive directly through us. You don't have to go looking for it. If you are Chicago local, reach out to me. I'll let you know what stores you can pick it up in. It is amazing stuff, and it's not really that much more expensive than any other probiotic. Okay, the other thing I'm going to tell you about is you need a good, trusted, tested recipe, right? You don't want to make rolls for the first time Thursday morning and have them fail and be like, oh no, I can't have any bread, and go insane, right? So you want to, we've all been there. I'm getting hearts. Yes, we've all been there. Yesterday I made rolls twice because we're practicing egg-free. Egg-free is new for us. I actually found out I have an egg allergy, and it's kind of interesting. Our youngest has an egg allergy as well. which made me go get tested for it. So what I want to tell you about is this week we're going to give you a gift, right? A gift of gratitude from our family to you directly. Starting tomorrow, you'll be able to go over to Amazon and download our Celebrates Heritage cookbook. Now, the reason I'm telling you this and why you want to go get this off Amazon is these recipes are family traditions that have been tested for years that are gluten and dairy free. They may not be egg free. They may not be onion free, garlic free. I know Tara's got allergies like that, but they are gluten free, dairy free. They're going to turn out with Earth Balance. They're going to turn out with gluten free flour. This whole cookbook was designed and tested around Namaste flour. Okay. So Namaste, this is how we store it here, is top 8 free. You can get it at Costco anymore. Amazon, they come in 5-pound bags or smaller, but it's casein-free, non-GMO, organic. I'm dancing it around. You can't even read the label. Namaste flour, okay? So when you pick up this weekend, like I said, our gift to you for Thanksgiving, our gratitude for you for being our peeps and our family for the year and sharing stories with us and laughing with us and crying with us, is that you're going to get a copy of Celebrates Heritage for free. Just flip over to Amazon. It will be a Kindle version, but you can get a Kindle reader to go on any device. You know, you can put it on your iPad, your phone, your Android device. You just download the free app. Now, inside of here, this is laid out by geographic locations, right? My husband's family was originally from Mississippi. My family came from the Midwest. His family then migrated, because that's what we did, right? We all migrated at some point. His family migrated to Indiana, and then eventually we both migrated to Chicago. So there's different chapters that go with different stuff. But what you're going to want to pick up on for Thanksgiving, right? That's what we're talking about. It's all tested for you. Apple crisp, apple pie. There's a pie crust in here that's awesome. You can do sweet potato pie. I mean, that's a tradition for Thanksgiving, right? The sweet potatoes, and you use an almond milk or a coconut milk, so it's a dairy-free sweet potato pie. If you need a thicker milk, here I'm giving you all my secrets, right? But I do that, right? Family, we share. You call me, I tell you what you need. You may not like what I tell you, but I always tell you what you need. So canned coconut milk is thick enough that it will work in replacement for whipping cream or heavy cream. So we're going to use canned coconut milk in the sweet potato pie. Your candy carrots are in here. Your baked squash is in here as well for Thanksgiving. There is a gravy recipe in here that you can use for Thanksgiving as well. I am flipping through macaroni and cheese. I mean, what Southern family doesn't want mac and cheese on Thanksgiving? I know it's not like traditional East Coast, but if you're from the South, we still want our mac and cheese on Thanksgiving. Okay, your pie crust, pecan pie. There's a potato soup, but I don't do potato soup on Thanksgiving. That's more like a Christmas Day grab-and-go dish. Rice pudding. Rice pudding. My great-grandma used to make rice pudding with raisins. So there's a rice pudding recipe in here as well if you want a rice pudding. I know that's sometimes more Christmas, but it is here. And then, but the big things are the sweet pickles, the sweet potato pie, the German chocolate cake, the banana pudding is in here, and the vanilla wafer recipe. That is a winner for a holiday. Your green beans, your mashed potatoes, you know, all of that is gluten-free anyway, dairy-free. Your turkey, just make sure you don't get an injected turkey. Get a turkey that's all natural. You're going to pay a little more for it, but it's not going to be injected with all of the sodium and the MSGs that are going to react if you have celiac disease or another intolerance. So just get a plain old bird, just like if somebody were to go out in the backyard and kill the turkey for you and serve it up. Doesn't need to be processed. It just needs to be, you know, a bird. So that is what is in Celebrate Heritage. The other thing in here is you'll kind of, if you pick up the book and you're flipping through it, there's stories and there's pictures of our family as we grew up. And it's just truly a coming together of families. So that is, again, starting tomorrow, hop over to Amazon. Our gift for you, our gratitude is Mom Certified Celebrates Heritage. Okay, couple other things really quickly. Going up on the blog today, I'm going to have, it'll probably be later today because we're taking the kids out for an adventure. I'm going to have a giveaway along with our Thanksgiving special ideas just for you. So we have a brand new Love with Food box. And if you know anything about the gluten-free community, you know this is awesome. So I'm going to give this away. Never opened. And It's just going to be a fun prize. So this will be up on the blog for a giveaway, and then we'll draw the winner either end of this week, early next week. But I'll put a raffle copter up so you guys can all register for that. And then just have a wonderful Thanksgiving. I'm so thankful for just everything that you guys give us. You give us joy, but you also give me challenges every year with things, you know, new food allergies or new recipes that you personally are looking for. And I get to play with that, and it's very gratifying for me. So thank you. Have a happy Thanksgiving. We'll talk to y'all soon.